Hello everyone, I am Sriranjani from Product Marketing team here at MathWorks. In this video, let's look into the IoT Device Builder app, a new capability added from 2023 B release for Simulink support package for Arduino. This app allows you to create a custom Simulink block to interface any sensors and peripherals that is connected to your Arduino board. By following the on-screen instructions, you would be easily able to create a custom Simulink block for your sensor. Here, I'd be explaining the IoT Device Builder app with the help of an example of interfacing the DHT11 sensor with my Arduino Uno board. You can use the same logic to interface other sensors by creating your own custom Simulink block. Before getting started, there are two prerequisites that you need to fulfill. First, make sure that you have Simulink support package for Arduino downloaded. You can quickly do that by navigating to the Apps tab in the Simulink Tools strip. And by clicking on Get Add-ons and Get Hardware Support Package, you'd be able to open the Add-on Explorer window where you can type in Simulink Support Package for Arduino hardware to get it installed. Secondly, ensure that you have necessary Arduino library files downloaded for your sensor. For this demo, I have downloaded the library files for the sensor from GitHub and placed them in a separate folder like this. Now, let me open a blank Simulink model. Let me configure this blank model for Arduino Uno hardware. For that, press Ctrl E to open the configuration parameters. In the hardware implementation section and in the hardware board, select Arduino Uno. Once you have your board selected, click on OK to apply the configuration. Once the model is configured for my hardware, you could see a new hardware tab appears on the Simulink tool strip displaying the selected hardware board. In our case, it's Arduino Uno. Now, let's get started with the IoT Device Builder app. Expand on the Prepare section and choose the IoT Device Builder app from the Design section. You could see a new welcome window opened for the IoT Device Builder app. Click on Next to begin. Here, in the Source Files location screen, select the working directory. In this working directory, a Simulink model containing the IoT device block, which you will be generating it shortly, along with the header files, C++ files, and the system object would be generated. Now, select the third-party source files folder. For that, click on Add Folder and navigate to the folder where you have initially downloaded the source files. So, select these folders. Again, click on Add Folder to add the DHT sensor library. Here, in the process of adding the path for the third-party source files, make sure to add the root containing the source files and please note that subfolders are not added along with it. If you have any utility folders within it, make sure to add the path of those folders separately. Once you have selected the working directory and the source file folders, click on Next to proceed. In the source files screen, you could see all the C and C++ files has been pulled in from the folders that you have added in the previous screen. Select the files you need to include for this project. In my case, I am selecting all the C++ files that are available. Click on Next to proceed. Here, in the block parameters screen, provide a block name. In my case, it's DHT11 and I'll mention the block description as this block is used to measure temperature and humidity. And you can add the block parameter that appears on the block. So for this application, I'm mentioning data delay as one of the block parameters. Let the data type be unsigned integer 32-bit. And in working with MATLAB, since all the numbers are stored in the matrix format, even a singular number is stored in a 1x1 matrix. Therefore, I'll keep the dimension to 1x1. Let me leave the initial value to 0 and let me keep it as tunable so that I can tune this parameter during the runtime. If you want to add more parameters, you can use this add button or you can use the remove to remove any of the parameters. And you can use this move up and move down option to choose the order in which the parameter needs to be displayed. Once you have added your parameters, now click on Next to proceed to the output screen. Here, you can add and define the block output. In my case, the output would be temperature. And humidity. And let me keep the data type to single. And leave the dimension to 1 cross 1. Let me click on next to add inputs to the block. Since it's a temperature and humidity sensor, there are no inputs that is required for this block. So let me remove this. And let me click on next to see the final block image. You could see a custom DHT11 block with temperature and humidity sensor as an output port. You can go back to any of the previous screens to edit the block parameters, input and output port at any point of time. If you are satisfied with the preview of the block, click on next and click on generate. You could see a C++ file, a header file, a MATLAB file, that is the system object file, and a Simulink model has been generated. Once you have successfully generated these files, you can click on finish and a C++ file automatically opens. You could see in the working directory that a source file, header file, system object file and a Simulink model has been generated. In the C++ file, there are few lines of code that are need to be modified, and let's see how to modify those files. Make sure you do not edit this app generated header file. Now let me add arduino.h and include few more header files. Please note that an object file has been created for this sensor by the app, which you can see here under the class section. Let me add few lines of code to define the input pin number. Here, the digital pin 4 of Arduino is connected to the data pin of the DHT11 sensor for communication, and define the DHT type. Also, I have declared a variable delay MS in unsigned integer 32-bit format. Now, let's move on to the setup function. Here, let me add few lines of code to begin the serial communication with a baud rate of 9600, initialize the sensor, and assign the data delay that we have declared as one of the parameter in the block to the delay MS variable that I have initially declared. Moving on to the step function, I have added few lines of code where I have called delay, temperature function, and humidity function to get the temperature and humidity values respectively, and assigned these values to the output port. Since the C++ file is used for creating a wrapper function, it is advisable to use the example code that is available in the library folder. Also, if you have any existing code that you want to integrate, you can use a similar approach. Coming back to our working directory, let me save the C++ file and open the minimized Simulink model and add a MATLAB system block. Double clicking on this block opens the block parameter. So you could see here there is an option to add the system object. And let me add the DHT11 system object that we have created using the app. Let me click on apply and OK. You could see a custom Simulink block for DHT11 sensor has been added via this MATLAB system block using the generated DHT11 system object. You can either bring in DHT11 Simulink block via this method or open the app generated Simulink model from here. You could see a custom DHT11 block that is built from the IO device builder app with a temperature and humidity as an output port. Double clicking on the block opens the block parameter, and you could see the parameter data delay, which we have defined it as an unsigned integer 32 bit with an initial value of 0. And you can give any value since it is a tunable parameter. You could also see the block's description displayed over here. Let me click on OK. Now, let me add a display to see the temperature and humidity value. Before running the model, I have my hardware set up. The connections are straightforward as mentioned in the wiring diagram, that the data pin of the DHT11 sensor is connected to the digital pin D4 of Arduino Uno, and the VCC and ground pin of the DHT11 sensor is connected to the 3.3 volt pin and ground pin of the Arduino Uno respectively. And I have powered the Arduino Uno board with the help of an USB cable. With the hardware set up, let me click on Monitor and Tune. And you could see temperature and humidity values are being displayed. Let me stop the simulation. To conclude, the example created for the DHT11 sensor highlights the potential of the IO device builder app. It demonstrates how you can effortlessly design and customize your own Simulink block for your IO devices without extensive programming knowledge. Thank you for watching this video. I look forward to seeing many incredible projects you will create using IO Device Builder app. Thanks again.